figuring out how I want to plug the hole in the front end for the Raggedy Ann car and start on some of the body work, get it ready to paint it or wrap it or collar it, however I'm going to do it. Here is the hole. My thoughts are to form a piece of cardboard, get it in there, shape it, and kind of plug it in, and then probably fiberglass over it. We'll see how it works. I might come up with something different. Starting to get somewhat of a fitment to it. Still a work in progress. I'm not happy with the way it's fitting, but give a little idea of what I got going on. Alright, now we got ourselves a slight change of plans. I have decided, it looks like this hole was molded in here, out this way. So I'm going to cut it in here and then start working it back. Just cut the whole damn thing out. Try to anyway. I already started cutting it. Bad idea, but we'll see what comes of it. Out of the way. I'm gonna start trimming this down and getting it ready for some fiberglass, I guess. I'll make a little template to go in there, probably. That's the one I have made to set inside the deal there, but it's now not gonna work. So I'll make another one, get this all cleaned up, and try to move forward. There you go, you can kind of see where I'm going with it. We got a lot of grinding done on it. Backside's ground down, front side's kind of ground down. I did learn that there is a whole bunch of mud in it. This is all them body lines and stuff is just all Bondo. So I guess I'm gonna follow suit with this front end, and whenever I fill this hole, I'll just build everything up back the way it is and see if I can get it straight. But it's a mess right now. So what I got going on here is I cut a little bit of the fiberglass out of the wrecked parts from the old Raggedy Ann to try to get a backer. I got some ducting, the metal ducting tape, to get the form of the curve there. Run that apart. It's pretty stiff. And I am now going to cut some fiberglass mat and mix up some fiberglass resin and lay a piece of fiberglass in here to get the start of filling this in. Once I've got a solid piece up front here, or a couple pieces, however it works out, then I'll try and pull all this off from the back and fill the back in. At least that's my idea. Fill in the turbo hole or procharger hole or whatever the hole was for. That's what it looks like on the back side. Literally just cut it with scissors, cut it to fit however. It don't have to be perfect because a lot of it's going to get ground out. But I do want it to sit back in underneath all this Bondo. This thing's loaded with Bondo, so I got all kinds of room to make mistakes, I guess. Got plenty to fill in. Now to do another one. This is one of the cardboard pieces I was forming to try to do the backing thing. Ended up not using it, as you can see. So I just stick it up there and cut it out. I'd say a lot of that should be good to go. Two layers there. Got a hole right here to patch in a little bit too. All right, so I got some resin in here, which I'm not sure is enough. Probably isn't. Probably should get more. Got a little bit more there. About that much. Put some drops of this hardener in it. It says. I'm supposed to count them, but it kind of just came out. Uncountable. And we gotta mix it up. Alright, I think I got it mixed up. At least I hope it is. If not, we're about to be in bad shape. Probably put a little more in it just in case. Just in case. Definitely don't want it to not harden up. It's kind of an ugly process. Unnecessary one, I guess, in this case anyway. So much mess. that's when it starts getting nasty. I think that's about what we got on this one. So it's starting to get hard. And you can touch it out here and it's not all wet. So I went ahead and peeled some of the back of it off to see if it would hold shape. And it did. So I'm going to try and peel the rest of it off. And then, it's still wet back here, though. Now I might go ahead and cut some more, mix it up, and go ahead and put it on the inside here. See if we can't get it close anyway. All right, I peeled the bottom piece off right here. I'm going to try and get this top piece off before it gets too hard. Hopefully. There we go. Now it says that I can mix up more and go ahead and do this because it's not completely hardened. So, cut some more fiberglass and mix up some more resin and coat this whole thing here. Alright, we're getting this on. I got the resin all mixed up and then forgot to hit play, so hopefully this works out. I feel like that should be stout enough to cover with all. Now it's all coming off on me. is fiberglass hole covered, or a big hole fiberglass in, however you want to look at it. Hopefully I mixed up enough to do this. Knot in it right there. Hopefully this will work. I just folded that one up to try to fill it because there's a big dent in it right there.
To build it up?
Yeah. Try to, anyway. I should have cut that instead of folding it. That'll get, probably have to get ground off. Alright, it is all coated in ish, I guess. Wait for it to set up and get good and hard. It says like 2.5 hours or something like that, but we'll see how long I'm out here messing around. I might be able to get something done with it this evening. I may just wait until tomorrow. Mixed up here. Trying to make something happen. ain't no show car.
That's for sure.
Making something out of it.
Alright, we'll let that sit, start setting up, and try to do something with it.
Got some primer here. I'm gonna prime the front end and see just how bad it looks. And go from there. This primer is very old. I'm hoping it's even good. It was all chunked up on the bottom, so we'll spray it on there and see how it does. Now I'll be wiping it off and going to buy a new. And we got a coat of primer on it. I'm gonna put several more coats on it, but I can already see some stuff I gotta fix or take care of, not so much fix, but it's coming around. My gun was messing up in the beginning. You can see a bunch of crap in it there, but now I'm putting the primer on really thick. I shaped it with 36 grit and 40 or whatever it is, 60. And then priming the crap out of it. And block it. Still getting primer up there. We got it running now. Actually mixed up too much primer, I think, so I'm just running it out now, put it all on, but I typically put a lot on, especially this first coat, try to fill in all the scratches. That's just the way I do it. I got all that primer I mixed up on it. I'm gonna let it completely dry, and then I'm gonna block it and fill in a couple spots, the blemishes, and then reprimer and block it some more. Don't look too awful bad for a first little deal there, I don't think, though.